Masters of Analytics.
Australia's at its peak right now with data analysts and courses and jobs around that area. One person in particular, I know they got sponsored by their company. RMIT doesn't have exams for coding subjects.
Yep, that's fine. Keep the camera. Okay, there's that. Hi guys, hi, hello and welcome back to another vlog. This is Caps Lock with Ashwati in RMIT Melbourne City Campus. And today we are going to talk about a video, a topic or something, which is pretty unusual to find and pretty important for people because I'm getting so many comments on asking where can we get a video on that and when can we get a video on that. So this is the video. Masters of Analytics in RMIT University or in Australia, because I feel it's going to be similar in other universities as well. So here's Ashwati. She's doing a Masters of Analytics in RMIT since
last year.
It's your second semester, third
it's
semester?
It's my third semester and my final year.
It's 2 years course, right?
2 years course. There are four semesters and I'm in my third sem right now.
Of course. How are you feeling? Left.
It's pretty good. It's going pretty well. It's peak assignment season, so you know.
Yeah, assignments are assignments.
Right? Yeah, I know.
So this is going to be really informal and honest video. Yeah. So the first question, not a question, we'll come on the questions later. The first thing is, as you said that she's a domestic person, but still, if you would be an international student, because you know the things, why Australia? Why did a person, or why did you choose Australia to be?
I think the main thing with Australia and courses like data analytics is that there are a lot of companies looking for people in that field right now. Mm-hmm. And there are a lot of companies that are moving towards data and data solutions, data-driven solutions mainly. So being in that era of technology where AI is such a huge thing and data is growing so much, you would need people like, you know, analysts, data scientists or business analysts to be there to actually help the companies to grow and understand the data, you know. So Australia's at its peak right now with data analysts and courses and jobs around that area. So it'd be a nice thing to do. That's
all. Okay. And talking about the university, why did a person or why would you choose our RMIT?
RMIT over anything else?
Mm-hmm.
One thing is RMIT's location. It's amazing. It's in the middle of the city. You get to go out, have your food, your drinks, you know, go out with your buddies, whatever. It's an amazing place to be. So even if you look at like other campuses, it's more towards the suburbs. You have to catch a bus or something else. You just catch a train from wherever you are, or you can just catch a tram within the city to get to RMIT's campus. So, you know, it's
very
much easier.
Close to come from, even from the Melbourne Central station.
Yeah, Melbourne Central. And, you know, in between classes, you're like, oh, I want to go to France or something. And you're just like, oh, let's go to Melbourne Central and just eat some food. Or you just go to some of the food courts around. So amazing location, number one. Number two is RMIT has a lot of industry opportunities and also the connections that RMIT holds with other industries is huge as well. I've heard a lot of companies who come to RMIT to get graduates as well. So it's a good hub for technology in general. I know a lot of other unis do specialize in science. There are some unis who specialize in like, you know, philosophy and things like that. But RMIT's core for design, technology and engineering. So
it's a good place to be. Yeah. Okay. So this was the overall idea of about RMIT Australia. And now comes about the course, Masters of Analytics, right?
Yeah.
So
what do you want to know?
Everything. Everything that's not present on website.
Yeah.
Before starting with the video, if you want to have the basic knowledge, the basic written knowledge, go to the website, search Masters of Analytics in RMIT or in any other university. You will get the overall idea. But now we're going to talk about something which is like an honest, original student perspective about the course. Okay, so quickly, what's the fee structure? What's the affordability?
I know for me, it costs about $4,000 per subject. So it depends on the number of subjects you're doing, and also it depends on the electives you're choosing, because most of analytics is electives. There is about seven core subjects and nine electives.
Yep.
So most of your things go towards electives. So it depends purely on what electives you're choosing.
Yep.
But ballpark, you get about 4K per subject. Mm-hmm. So that's what you're looking at. So 4K, there are four subjects you do each semester. So do the math, about 33K-ish altogether.
Per semester.
No, per year. For the whole course.
For the whole course, $30,000, $34,000, something.
Around
but that's for the domestic student.
Yeah.
If you're international, it's going to be, I guess, $2,000 extra. Okay. Not much difference. But also depends on if you're going to get, you know, scholarship in your, through your bachelor's, Okay, and you can have obviously exact knowledge through website because the piece is something that's always changing.
Yeah.
It's always getting enhanced, right?
Yes.
So, the next thing is how the lecturers are, how the professors are. of this course?
I've been lucky. I've had some very great lectures. They're very helpful. So once you, I think the most important thing with lectures is that if you go to them and you build a bond with them, they're very active in helping you out, let's say with your assignments, they'll help you out with your resume, they'll help you out with doing mock interviews, let's say, even if you want to apply for like Mecca's or KOC, they'll help you do the interviews for it.
Is it?
Yeah, yeah. I had a few lecturers actually who are really sweet. Yeah. And you know, it's a university, you have ups and downs. There are some lecturers who are not.
I would like
great
to know
well,
what downs
you know?
Are downs as well.
The downs as well, there are a few lectures, there are a few, I feel like one particular subject that I was looking into, but that was an elective, so I can't say it's particular to the course, but I felt like the course was very outdated, and the teacher wasn't very updated as well with what's happening in the world. And the course itself wasn't very tech savvy, let's say. It's not something you would use in a real world, but I just chose it as an elective.
It's more of a theoretical course.
Yeah. So there is stuff like that where the lecturer themselves are new to the whole teaching perspective as well, so they're kind of learning with you, but you know, bear with them. I feel like they're learning with us. So
the thing is, if you just keep on working hard with your assignments, they're going to be fine.
They're happy to help you out.
And most of them, I guess, apart from studies, they are kind of chill people, so they don't have any issue, right?
They don't care.
In addition, the next question comes up is, now that's a broader question, so I'll just be really up to the whatever you think. So what's the course structure of this course? I mean, something that a person can know only from your perspective, from a student perspective.
The course structure of this course, I think the main thing you need to look at is that you need to finish seven core subjects. And with the seven core subjects, they're compulsory subjects we have to get done. So you'll have machine learning, you'll have stuff that are math and coding heavy that you need to finish. And it's a bit of a struggle. I wouldn't make it polished and be like, you know, it's amazing. It's struggle, but it's something you're learning, and it's very industry relevant at this point. So it's a hard subject to start off with and learn, but I think it goes really well in your resume when you're applying. You know, when you're applying, I've been applying for jobs because there are grad roles opening up for the final year and stuff. And everything they look at is, you know, you've done machine learning, you've done regression analysis, let's say, stuff like that. So they really want those points in your transcript. So they know what they're looking at. So it goes well in your resume. But it's a hard subject to do. I can't polish it.
So, but it's just, is there any way so that a person can keep it in mind and it will be easy for that person if he or she learned that particular skill beforehand, before coming to this?
If you know Python, you have to. That's something I would recommend knowing before coming into
Python.
Or you have basics in R and stuff like that. It's very helpful because they don't go through the basics of Python when they're teaching you machine learning, or you have advanced programming Python and things like that. So whatever subject you choose, you should make sure you know the basics of Python. At least they do give you modules on how to learn the basics of Python and how to use the Jupyter Notebook and things like that. But they don't spend time teaching it with you. So it's like you have to learn it yourself. It's self-learning. They expect, it's like expected knowledge before you come into a machine learning, because that's such a high level subject that you're learning. So when you're walking into that, they kind of expect you to know all that.
That
so
you would be knowing this.
You know basics in Python. Won't expect you to like fully code in Python. You just need to know the basics, to understand
the beginner levels.
And do like certain, you know, just do your little coding, do little Python projects or something. It'll help.
It's getting chilly.
It's getting cold.
The next thing is, what are the future pathways or roles that come up after doing this course?
You can get into any analyst role there is. You can do data science, you can do business analyst. Business analyst is more the non-programming version of the analyst, let's say. You do a lot of diagrams and things like that. So you can be business analyst, you can be a data scientist, data analyst, and all of those kind of things, basically. Those are kind of the ranges.
But this is the major part. You can just get subparts
from
these jobs.
If you look at
junior levels, medium level.
You can get in as in this interns, there's juniors, there's senior analysts, there is even business analysts, you have junior business analysts, senior business analysts, things like that. So when you're entering, you just get into a graduate role, either so be a graduate data scientist or graduate data analyst. I heard there was a new thing that's coming up that's called graduates in data technology and design.
It's like a new role coming
It's a new role.
Relatable to AI, probably?
Which is more into marketing, if I'm not wrong. But it's analyst for marketing. You know what
Checking
I mean?
Checking the data.
So it's very analytical based. So people from, you know, who's doing massive analytics or you're doing data science, in general could get into that field as well. So that's another opportunity. I've seen, because I told you, I've been applying for jobs recently. So I've been seeing a lot of that coming up as well. So that's something.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of roles. There's a lot of opportunities coming up.
It's just you need to check on it, right?
Yeah.
And yeah. Okay, so here comes the last question of the video, which is, I mean, you're a domestic student, but still, if you have knowledge, honest knowledge, related to PR, permanent residency after getting into this course, after doing this course, a person wants to stay in Australia.
Yeah.
How can he or she be? Whatever you know.
Yes. I haven't dealt with it personally, but I do know friends who are international students. And one person in particular, I know they got sponsored by their company. They were working for a startup company. And the company decided to sponsor them to stay in Australia. So that's one pathway they found. And I'm pretty sure you can like gather points and things like that. I don't know about the specifics of the PR, but I'm pretty sure there are other ways to get the PR as well, rather than the course itself.
But it depends on, after doing the study, you need to have the work experience in that particular study.
I think if
that comes up under the skill occupation list, which keeps on upgrading every year, then you can probably apply for the permanent residency. But okay.
So sponsorship's like a huge thing though. So if you can find a company that can sponsor you, you can do it.
The last thing, it's not a question.
Okay.
What's your personal experience about RMIT, Australia, people, anything you like, anything you dislike?
Yeah.
Be honest.
Yeah, of course.
There you go.
RMIT is amazing, number one. I think I made an amazing choice choosing RMIT within all the universities. I don't know. I don't have experience with other unis. I can't talk about them, but it's just that the experience I've had at RMIT is so good that I wouldn't have it any other way, basically.
Yep.
I was involved with a lot of the clubs as well in and around RMIT. I was part of the Indian club. I was part of the dance groups around here. So there are a lot of dance events. For Indian club, we have a lot of Indian celebrations that we do around as well. So
check the other videos. Yes. She'll be there.
I know. Look at his videos. I'll be somewhere in the background if you can spot me. But
that's fine. Keep the camera. Okay, there's absolutely.
If there's any dance videos, I'll probably be somewhere. But it's amazing. There's a huge community here, not just with Indians, just in general. And everyone's very supportive of each other. So even if you want to celebrate your own cultural events, I know for like Diwali and stuff, we turn up in our cultural dresses and we like celebrate, we do the dances. You were there, of course. And we do all those things like that. So it's so fun. The community itself is really sweet. So I enjoy being in RMIT.
Something you dislike?
Something I dislike.
Or that you want to be changed in a course, curriculum or anything?
Oh yeah, some courses are backdated. I'll tell you that over and over again. They haven't revamped and I feel like they're not fully... I personally found it really nice that RMIT doesn't have exams for coding subjects.
Yep.
Personally, I hate writing code on a paper. Like doing it on my laptop, just like
obviously it's code, man.
Why can't someone
be writing it on a paper,
so,
right?
I wasn't a fan of writing code on a paper and doing exams, but good thing there are no exams for coding around here. So
technically helping your eyes to reheal, but
exactly. Yeah. But the coding projects are they're a challenge.
Oh, challenge?
Yeah,
my bad.
They're a challenge,
man.
It could be fun, you know, it could be a fun challenge.
If you like it. If you know Python in advance.
Yeah. It wouldn't be just Python. You'll have other stuff as well. You have SQL and things. But it depends on which subject your course is doing at that time. And also the language keeps changing as, you know, the industry keeps changing. So even though the subject's name is the same, they might use a different language. You might use R instead of Python for that course for that particular semester. So it's something they do as well. So that's something. Yeah. Another thing I don't enjoy. It's really hard to find stuff that I don't enjoy around here, to be honest. Maybe timetables. There are a lot of clashes sometimes.
But that can be solved.
It can be solved, but then you just need to figure it out yourself.
It's
something, and you have gaps between your classes. It could be a positive and a negative. You could go out and enjoy with your friends.
But if you don't have friends, then you need to sit around.
Yeah.
Make friends. It's easy to make friends.
Very easy to make friends.
But you just need to be a little bit ambivert or extrovert. Don't be an introvert in Australia. But yeah, it is what it is.
Yeah. I mean, you're moving countries. I'm pretty sure you're going to be an extrovert.
You're going to be confident enough. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So yeah, there you go.
So this was the course. This was Ashruti sharing her experience. I'm going to mention her Instagram coming up just here. Make sure to have, you know, questions and ask her whenever you get time.
Or you
can comment down below whenever you get time.
Yeah.
Come on the same video.
Yeah.
Answer them up. My Instagram is also in description. Like, share and subscribe to this video. And write down any questions or anything that you want us in the comment section.
Yeah, sure.
Bye.